Mr. Jonathan, sir, please come in.
This place always makes my flesh crawl.
You're right to be wary, and if I may be so bold, I should avoid going into that room when I'm not around.
Jonathan, at last you're here.
We were so worried.
I'm here, and I'm all right.
So then, what did you discover?
It seems that Carfax is not quite as deserted as we thought.
I see what you mean. I've been noticing some very odd things there for some time now. All this is becoming rather disturbing.
Have you found anything out about that ring that I brought back?
I've been able to reconstruct its history, thanks to Mina, who has transcribed the wax cylinders which were recorded as a favor to me by a historian friend of mine.
My attacks are so frequent that I don't have much time to work, and Seward insisted that I rest, but I wanted to help you.
What have you discovered?
The last known trace of the ring was back in 1442. It seems it belonged to Radu, a Romanian prince and the half-brother of Dracula. But there's more to it. Apparently, the ring is incomplete.
In fact, in the engravings described, the ring is shown with a kind of diamond in its center. According to my friend's documents, this stone had the virtue of counterbalancing the evil side of the ring. We don't know anymore, but it's certain that Dracula will do everything he can to get it back.
Does the name Styx mean anything to you?
It's the river of hell in Greek mythology, but I think it's also the name of a theater in London, isn't it?
Yes, in fact it's all the rage now. A hall where a cinematographer shows horror films. There's a mystery surrounding the identity of the owner, but I've done some investigating and have found nothing in the least bit suspicious.
You'd better think again. I found proof at Carfax that Dracula is the owner of the Styx.
My God, I've read that all London is lining up to go there.
It's a fact that we cannot ignore, but it's very unlikely that the Styx is our principal target. To defeat Dracula once and for all, we have got to find his lair and strike at the heart.
I confess, I just don't know what to do now.
Mina, if you aren't too tired, perhaps you and I could have another try at hypnosis.
I'm ready to do anything rather than stay under Dracula's yoke forever. Doctor, let's go.
Your eyes are closing. Your spirit is roaming free. What do you see?
I see a garden of stone, a shadow walking. He's coming to find me. I can hear voices still make me go mad. Help me!
Mina, you will sleep now. Sleep. Sleep. She describes the same scene at each session. I think the stone garden must be the cemetery at Highgate.
Highgate, you say? Now that Mina is asleep, I can tell you that my visit to Carfax nearly cost me my life. But a man called Peabody was not so lucky. I found his body. And it seems that he worked at Highgate.
Peabody dead. He was investigating on my behalf. He said that he had seen some strange goings-on near a tomb decorated with a stone wolf. It's more than likely that the cemetery is where Dracula has his secret sanctuary. Take this key and go over there. It will be safer to go via the sewers. I shall stay here with me.
Thank you. Well, well, just in time, as the master said. It just needs your corpse, and my work will be finished. And then I shall get my reward. Prepare to die. Oh, but don't worry. I shall make sure it's slow and extremely painful.
Notes on the patient Hopkins. Height, 1 meter 65, weight, 55 kilograms, estimated age between 40 and 45. Date of internment, 20th October 1904. The patient Hopkins seems to have been afflicted by a very rare carnivorous pathology, which takes the form of ingesting flies and other insects and other forms of disturbed behavior. What is particularly interesting is that after a series of conversations with him, I became deeply convinced that the man's mind was controlled by Dracula. And then, though Hopkins seemed so cold and calculating that it was possible to believe that he was feigning his illness, he met Mina and was radically transformed. From then on, he has spoken hesitantly and seems far less sure of himself. He has become vulnerable. If Hopkins has doubts, that could be to our advantage. From today onwards, Mina must be present during my sessions with him.
God be praised. I am now protected against the vampires.
Jonathan has already been gone for several hours, and Mina is resting in my office. It is a pity that, because of the urgency of the situation, I have not been able to bring Jonathan up to date with all my work. I have a feeling that the noose is tightening around us, and... But what? My God! It's Dracula!
Leave your guard where you found him. He's of no use to you now. Seize him!
Don't go near her. Get away.
Get him out of my sight. Now, my dear, it appears that our destinies have crossed once again. Let me just relieve you of that wedding ring, which you won't be needing any longer. Now wake up. This time, I promise you, we shall never part again.
My dear colleague, after your cable concerning the dragon's ring, I found a document which used to belong to a scientist friend of mine who died recently. It consists of a notebook whose contents have a curious relevance to the things you told me about in your letter. It contains information on vampires and initiation rites, secret sanctuaries, and the ring. I am sure that you will find it very interesting. On the subject of the transcription of the anti-vampire projectiles in the notebook, A temperature is indicated, which I would advise you to raise by 5 degrees, as the blood included in the composition should thicken the solution.
Delicious. This fly is a real treat.
Hopkins, what happened to Mina and Dr. Seward? Tell me.
So you know my name. There's no need to introduce myself then. I've been dying to meet you.
Let's dispense with the formalities. I've got to know what happened here.
You're not in a position to demand anything. All you need to know is that the Master considered that the good Dr. Seward had become somewhat bothersome.
And Mina?
Madame Mina... The Master wants her. She's with him. Yes, she's with him.
Ah! Thank you.
Hopkins, look, I'm armed to fight Dracula. Help me to save Mina. You've seen her, you see how vulnerable she is.
But to save Mina would mean betraying the Master. I cannot act against the Master, but I can't leave Mina in danger either. What a terrible dilemma.
I've already beaten Dracula. Trust me, and together we can save Mina.
It'll take more than words to convince me. I know that you possess the dragon's ring. If you want me to trust you and help you, give it to me. That way you can let me be the judge of how sincere you are. Take these in exchange. Here are my spectacles. They will be extremely useful to you because they make common mortals see with a secret vision of the vampires. The Master is right to be wary of you. You're a brave man. I shall help Mina.
Nothing more than a rat lost in a labyrinth. But I'll have you know that this game no longer amuses me. Silence! In a little while, everything that is yours will be mine. Then your life will be worth no more than that of an insect. And I shall simply flick you away.